Welcome to Speed Pharmacology. Today, we'll be discussing the pharmacology of drugs used for the treatment of obesity. Obesity is a complex and multifactorial condition with genetic, environmental, and behavioral factors contributing to its development. Now, before we delve into the pharmacological interventions for weight management, let's first discuss the step-by-step biological mechanisms behind the development of obesity. Obesity occurs when there is an imbalance between energy intake and energy expenditure, leading to the excessive accumulation of body fat. The process starts with the consumption of food, which is broken down into its basic components, such as carbohydrates, proteins, and fats. These macronutrients provide the body with energy in the form of calories. When energy intake exceeds energy expenditure, the surplus energy is stored as triglycerides in adipocytes, the fat-storing cells. Over time, as more energy is consumed than expended, adipocyte hypertrophy, or the enlargement of individual fat cells, occurs, followed by adipocyte hyperplasia, which is an increase in the number of adipocytes. As adipose tissue expands, it undergoes remodeling and releases various adipokines, which are signaling molecules secreted by adipocytes. Some of these adipokines, like leptin, which is produced by adipocytes, and ghrelin, which is produced primarily by the stomach, play a role in regulating energy balance, appetite, and insulin sensitivity. However, in obesity, the normal function of these adipokines may be disrupted, contributing to the development of insulin resistance and inflammation. Inflammation in adipose tissue may lead to the infiltration of immune cells, such as macrophages, which exacerbate local and systemic inflammation, further contributing to insulin resistance and other obesity-related complications. The hypothalamus also plays a critical role in the regulation of energy balance and appetite. It receives signals from peripheral hormones, such as leptin and ghrelin, and responds by modulating appetite and energy expenditure. In obesity, the normal function of these hormonal signals may be impaired, leading to dysregulated appetite control and a perpetuation of weight gain. Now that we have an understanding of the biological mechanisms underlying obesity, let's explore the molecular mechanisms of action of various classes of weight loss drugs, starting with orlistat. Orlistat is a gastrointestinal lipase inhibitor that works by reducing the absorption of dietary fats in the intestines. Its mechanism of action is unique among the currently approved weight loss drugs, as it does not target the central nervous system or directly affect metabolism. Orlistat inhibits the function of pancreatic lipase, which is an enzyme responsible for breaking down dietary fats, specifically triglycerides, into smaller molecules called fatty acids and glycerol. This process, known as lipolysis, is essential for the absorption of fat by the small intestine. When a person takes orlistat with food, the drug binds to the active site of pancreatic lipase, effectively blocking its action. As a result, the triglycerides in the diet are not broken down and cannot be absorbed by the small intestine. Instead, they pass through the gastrointestinal tract unabsorbed and are eventually excreted in the feces. By blocking the absorption of approximately 30% of dietary fats, orlistat helps reduce the overall caloric intake, leading to weight loss over time. It is important to note that orlistat is most effective when combined with a reduced-calorie, low-fat diet, and regular physical activity as part of a comprehensive weight management program. All right, let's move on to another class of anti-obesity drugs, that is phendimetrazine, a sympathomimetic amine belonging to the drug class of anorectics or appetite suppressants. So, phendimetrazine functions as a prodrug, meaning that it is metabolized in the body to an active compound called phenmetrazine, which is responsible for the drug's appetite-suppressing effects. The mechanism of action for phendimetrazine involves the activation of the central nervous system, particularly the hypothalamus, which is the brain region that controls appetite. By increasing the levels of norepinephrine in the hypothalamus, phendimetrazine stimulates the fight-or-flight response, leading to increased energy expenditure and decreased food intake. This combination of increased energy use and reduced appetite results in weight loss. Phendimetrazine also has indirect effects on other neurotransmitters, such as dopamine and serotonin. By increasing the levels of these neurotransmitters, phendimetrazine may improve mood and reduce the desire for food, particularly in those who experience emotional eating. However, it is important to note that phendimetrazine is intended for short-term use, as its appetite-suppressing effects tend to diminish over time, and there is a potential for dependence and abuse. Now, let's move on to our next weight loss agent, phentermine-topiramate, a combination drug that contains two active ingredients, phentermine and topiramate. Phentermine is a sympathomimetic amine, similar to phendimetrazine, and belongs to the drug class of anorectics or appetite suppressants. Topiramate, on the other hand, is an anticonvulsant medication, initially developed to treat epilepsy and migraine, but later found to have weight loss effects when used in combination with phentermine. The mechanism of action of phentermine is similar to that of phendimetrazine, as it stimulates the release of norepinephrine, a neurotransmitter involved in the regulation of appetite and energy balance. By increasing the levels of norepinephrine in the hypothalamus, phentermine stimulates the fight-or-flight response, leading to increased energy expenditure and decreased food intake, thus contributing to weight loss. Topiramate, however, has a more complex mechanism of action. It affects several neurotransmitter systems, including enhancing the activity of the inhibitory neurotransmitter GABA, modulating the activity of the excitatory neurotransmitter glutamate, and inhibiting certain voltage-gated sodium and calcium channels. The exact mechanism by which topiramate contributes to weight loss is not fully understood, but it is believed to be related to its ability to modulate neurotransmitter activity and stabilize neuronal membranes. When used together, phentermine and topiramate have a synergistic effect on weight loss. The combination works by addressing both appetite and energy balance, making it more effective than either drug used alone. Additionally, the combination of these two drugs allows for lower doses of each medication, reducing the risk of side effects and improving tolerability. Continuing our discussion of weight loss medications, we now turn our attention to setmelanotide. As a member of the melanocortin receptor agonist drug class, this novel peptide drug has been specifically developed to treat obesity caused by genetic deficiencies in the melanocortin 4 receptor, MC4R, pathway. The MC4R pathway is a critical component of energy homeostasis regulation, with MC4R expressed in various regions of the brain, including the hypothalamus. This receptor plays a key role in regulating appetite and energy expenditure. The MC4R pathway is regulated by the melanocortin system, which includes the pro-opiomelanocortin, POMC, and agouti-related peptide, AGRP, neurons. The leptin receptors are situated on both POMC and AGRP neurons, and their presence on these neurons also plays a crucial role in the regulation of appetite and energy balance. Leptin exerts an inhibitory effect on AGRP neurons and a stimulatory effect on POMC neurons. Peptides derived from POMC, such as alpha-melanocyte-stimulating hormone, alpha-MSH, function as natural agonists for the MC4R, enhancing sensitivity to satiety signals and increasing energy expenditure. Conversely, AGRP, originating from AGRP neurons, functions as an antagonist for the MC4R, thereby intensifying hunger and diminishing energy expenditure. In individuals with genetic deficiencies affecting POMC, MC4R, or the leptin receptor, the intricate balance of this system is disrupted, leading to potential imbalances in appetite regulation and energy levels, resulting in excessive hunger and weight gain. Now, setmelanotide plays a crucial role as an MC4R agonist, binding to and activating the melanocortin 4 receptor to mimic the effects of alpha-MSH. This action facilitates the restoration of equilibrium between energy intake and expenditure in individuals with MC4R pathway deficiencies, ultimately promoting weight loss. Moving on to our next weight loss agent, that is naltrexone-bupropion, a combination drug consisting of two active ingredients, naltrexone and bupropion. Just like phentermine-topiramate, this combination medication works through a dual mechanism of action to help manage obesity. Naltrexone functions as an opioid antagonist, specifically targeting the mu-opioid receptors within the reward pathway of the central nervous system. By blocking these receptors, naltrexone modulates endorphin activity, ultimately diminishing the rewarding effects of food intake and resulting in a decreased desire to eat. Additionally, naltrexone is thought to enhance the release of POMC peptides, such as alpha-MSH, which suppresses appetite and promotes satiety. Bupropion, on the other hand, primarily affects the neurotransmitters dopamine and norepinephrine. It inhibits their reuptake, increasing their levels in the brain. This results in increased energy expenditure and reduced appetite. Bupropion also stimulates the release of POMC peptides, similar to naltrexone, further contributing to the suppression of appetite. The combination of naltrexone and bupropion creates a synergistic effect that enhances weight loss outcomes. By targeting different neurotransmitter systems and utilizing their complementary mechanisms, the combination of these two drugs allows for lower doses of each medication, reducing the risk of side effects and improving tolerability. Overall, naltrexone-bupropion is a unique combination that addresses both appetite and energy balance, making it an effective option for obesity management. Next, let's discuss the mechanism of action of liraglutide and semaglutide, which are both drugs from the glucagon-like peptide 1, GLP-1 receptor agonist class. GLP-1 receptor agonists are a class of injectable medications used for weight loss and diabetes management. Liraglutide and semaglutide are synthetic analogs of human GLP-1, a naturally occurring incretin hormone secreted by the L cells of the small intestine in response to food intake. The mechanism of action of liraglutide and semaglutide involves binding to and activating GLP-1 receptors located in various tissues, such as the pancreas, gastrointestinal tract, and central nervous system. Activation of these receptors has several effects that promote weight loss and improve glucose homeostasis. First, liraglutide and semaglutide stimulate insulin secretion from pancreatic beta cells in a glucose-dependent manner, meaning that insulin is released only when blood glucose levels are elevated. This helps to prevent hypoglycemia and enhances blood glucose control. Second, these drugs suppress glucagon secretion from pancreatic alpha cells. By inhibiting glucagon release, they decrease hepatic glucose production, thereby reducing blood glucose levels. Third, liraglutide and semaglutide slow gastric emptying, which prolongs the feeling of fullness and reduces food intake. This effect contributes to weight loss by promoting satiety and decreasing overall caloric consumption. Finally, liraglutide and semaglutide have been shown to directly act on the central nervous system, specifically on the hypothalamus, where they enhance satiety signaling and reduce hunger, further contributing to weight loss. These central effects may be mediated through the activation of GLP-1 receptors in the brain, or through indirect mechanisms such as vagal afferent signaling. In summary, liraglutide and semaglutide, as GLP-1 receptor agonists, exert their weight loss effects through a combination of actions on the pancreas, gastrointestinal tract, and central nervous system. These actions lead to enhanced insulin secretion, reduced glucagon release, slowed gastric emptying, and increased satiety, ultimately contributing to decreased food intake and weight loss. Tirzepatide is our final weight loss agent to discuss. Tirzepatide is a novel drug belonging to the class of dual glucose-dependent insulinotropic polypeptide, GIP, and glucagon-like peptide 1, GLP-1, receptor agonists. This drug is unique because it targets two incretin hormones, GIP and GLP-1, which play a crucial role in glucose homeostasis and appetite regulation. The mechanism of action of tirzepatide can be divided into four primary effects. Number one, enhanced insulin secretion. Similar to GLP-1 receptor agonists, tirzepatide stimulates glucose-dependent insulin secretion from pancreatic beta cells. This means that insulin is only released when blood glucose levels are elevated, minimizing the risk of hypoglycemia. Number two, suppressed glucagon secretion. Tirzepatide also suppresses glucagon secretion from pancreatic alpha cells in a glucose-dependent manner, leading to decreased hepatic glucose production and contributing to lower blood glucose levels. Number three, delayed gastric emptying. By slowing down gastric emptying, tirzepatide prolongs the feeling of fullness after a meal, which can help reduce overall food intake and promote weight loss. Number four, increased satiety signaling. Tirzepatide exerts its appetite-suppressing effects by enhancing satiety signaling in the central nervous system, specifically in the hypothalamus. This results in reduced hunger sensations and decreased food intake. Overall, tirzepatide's dual agonism of both GIP and GLP-1 receptors leads to better glycemic control and weight loss by enhancing insulin secretion, suppressing glucagon secretion, delaying gastric emptying, and increasing satiety signaling. And with that, I wanted to thank you for watching, and I hope this video has been informative and helpful to you. If you have any questions or feedback, please feel free to leave them in the comments below, and don't forget to subscribe for more educational content like this.